Welcome to LA Foodie. This is Drew and Ben, the food dudes. We're looking for the best food in LA and usually finding it.
On today's show, we pick on some pizza, contemplate cookies, and approve some ice cubes. Plus, Kasey's kitchen brings us tasty treats that I can't wait to put in our mouths. And Lisa shows us how to make cake as easy as 1, 2, 3. So grab yourself a brew and yank on the pull tab, because there's all that and more coming up on LA Foodie.
T-shirts, Ben.
T-shirts, I know.
Store.lafoodie.com.
Store.lafoodie.com.
Here's a good way to support LA Foodie. You wear shirts, we sell shirts. It's a perfect match. Yeah. They're cool. It's just, look.
I'm not wearing one right now.
Neither
but,
am I.
You know,
but someday we'll wear one on the show, yes. And we'll be like,
it's
hey, how cool
very
are these?
Soon. Yeah.
Anyway, it's a cool way to support the site. If you like what we do, we make a few bucks every time you buy a shirt. It's a cool shirt. There's no branding on it or anything. It says iBurger LA. They're fun. Check it out.
Yeah. And we've got a ton of variety of women's shirts.
Yeah. We have a lot of ladies' shirts.
A couple for the dudes.
So
not a lot of choices for dudes.
Lisa, if you would,
you don't want
because
a lot of
you helped us pick the shirts out, right? Yeah. Do you want to come talk to us about it for a second?
It's true. We got a mic.
Because I know
right
that
here.
You were.
I'm talking to...
Well, this is the two shot.
Yeah, this is the two shots. You got to come over here. Oh. Lean in close. Yeah. Hi.
Hello. This is not awkward at all.
Here. So you picked out the lady shirts because we, as dudes, are not qualified as all to be shirt pickers, and I'm not saying that in any kind
no,
of...
No, I had no idea.
exaggerated
I'm really
way, I mean
I'm
my
shirt to come in the mail. I'm excited.
Well, what kind of shirt did you end up getting? I can't remember.
I ended up getting a camisole tank top.
Okay.
And it's current colored, which
it's
I don't know.
Purple,
it's like a purple
and then I chose
pink sort of thing. Yeah.
Brown as the color of the bun for the lettering.
It's very
and
exciting.
I'm very excited.
Yeah. Nice. Yeah.
So bun colored lettering, people.
Oh yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You can't go wrong.
Yes.
All right.
Well,
so we just thanks, Lisa. We just want to let you know that there's lots of ladies' shirts. There might even be more women's shirts.
There's
than
definitely
men's.
More women's shirts than men's.
Yeah. So there's a lot of variety because I know that. The ladies have told us that it's annoying to go to t-shirt stores where there's just like the one t-shirt and it's pretty much for dudes.
Whereas men would like one or two shirts.
Right.
Men don't want to really like browse through a lot of shirts.
I mean,
you know, like
three options. Sexy spaghetti strap I'll get into.
Yeah, yeah. I know
but that's about
mean.
It.
Yeah. Well, that just works for your shoulders though. That just shows them off.
It's true. I've been thinking lately, just switching gears. Totally
yes.
away from
yes,
t-shirts.
Yes, please do. Yes. Let's talk about some food.
I was talking to my wife about willpower, and she pointed out to me that I have none at all
okay.
when it comes to cookies. I'm actually really good with other things,
okay.
right? Except maybe drinking.
Well, yeah, I can see that, yeah.
But
cookies.
I actually don't, I started thinking about it. I don't know anywhere in LA that has an awesome chocolate chip cookie. Because whenever I want cookies, I just kind of make them myself.
Right.
I don't go on a quest. And so I did some research, and I found a few places that seem to be people's favorites. One
right.
was Clementine
okay.
on Ensley Avenue. One is Beachy Cream in Santa Monica.
Okay, I know that place.
One that seems to be kind of newer that people have been freaking out about more lately
okay.
is the Larder at Maple Drive in Beverly Hills.
Okay. Is this someplace I'm going to have to wait in line for an hour or something? I
have
I don't know,
a feeling,
a right.
maybe.
Oh,
yeah.
All right.
I think some of these are.
Yeah.
Not
yeah.
all of them. Diddy Reese certainly is.
Diddy Reese, that place has been around forever, right? I mean,
yeah,
I've heard that
that's like
times.
The yeah. late night right. UCLA Westwood joint.
Gotcha.
Really
gotcha.
Good ice cream sandwiches.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's not like gourmet or anything. It's just,
sure.
it's a serviceable, functional ice cream sandwich that's tasty.
Okay.
And so it always shows up on top 10 lists. But I'm actually kind of curious. What you got, and we're going to ask our guests too because
obviously, yeah, yeah.
But do you have some place that you like going? Because
oh,
I need recommendations,
funny. Yeah. Cookies, I it's so rare that I go order cookies somewhere.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah,
so,
like
we
you
should,
get a box of cookies,
we should do this, you know, at an upcoming blog post or show or something. We should explore this because I feel stupid for how little I know about where to get a good cookie in the
city. It's ridiculous.
So we'll go
I don't really know, yeah, yeah. Well, speaking of quests for a specific type of food, LA Weekly, I'm sure you saw, this is earlier in August, put out their top 10 pizzas in LA.
Which was a head-scratcher for me.
Yeah,
a little bit.
I'm with you. Because, I mean, I haven't been to a bunch of the places.
There's
you know,
about
there's,
half the places on the list that neither of us have been to.
Yeah, it's very heavy on the Neapolitan-style pizza.
Right.
Like, the photo spread, I initially thought all the photos were from the same place. They're from, like, four different places, but they all deserve the same style of pizza.
On one hand, why not, right? Because it's awesome. But on the other hand, there are other styles of pizza.
I know. There was one deep dish entry on the whole list, and it wasn't masa.
Who was it?
It was Zillo Pizzeria in Arcadia. And I haven't been out there. I haven't been to Arcadia that much.
Well, we'll have to check it out.
We're going to have to check it out. I know. It sounds really good. And I like a deep dish. But,
well, the surprising one for me was 800 Degrees making it on the top 10 list. Because we did a review of 800 Degrees, and we were both kind of like, yeah, it's good, but it's not that good.
Right. Yeah. I mean, I saw somebody talking about it being like the new Subway.
Uh-huh.
Which it totally is. Right. That's, you know, because they figured out the oven. So now
and
they
since
can
when
do
does
the
Subway
little,
make? Like,
right,
the
yeah,
top
Subway,
10 list.
Your favorite sandwich in town. No, it's not.
The other one that you and I both forgot that we'd even been to was Olio Pizzeria.
Yeah, on 3rd Street.
Is it Olio or Olio?
I don't know.
Okay. But, well,
I read the review and I was like, okay. And then I looked at the address and I'm like, wait a minute. We've totally been to this place, and we didn't even really... We were kind of like, oh, this is fine. Like, it's not bad. But it was like their number 3 place on their top 10 list.
Right.
That's ridiculous.
Yeah, so putting 800 Degrees as number 10 and Olio as number 3, I think just sort of... I don't know.
It's tough. It's tough to
take
the list
with the credibility
seriously.
Of publication.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, there are places on here that I definitely need to go to. Like, I need to go to Mother Dough.
Well, we need to check them all out. Mother Dough is a no-brainer. Everybody
likes Mother Dough. Yeah.
I think what we have to do is we have to compile a regular guy pizza list.
I think
because some of these
right.
are crazy expensive. Number 5 is Jelena.
I mean,
come on. Almost everything at Jelena is good.
Sure.
But it's not a pizza joint. No. I mean, you know what I mean? It's like, oh, we should get a slice.
Let's get a Jelena.
Yeah, what the fuck?
No, it's not going to
happen. Jelena. So I think we should do, you know, your I don't know, Mulberry Street is the one that often comes to mind.
Yeah,
I don't
know,
think
like
it's
Mulberry.
The greatest in the city, but it's good, and it's that, you know, it's New York style. It doesn't have to be New York style, but it's affordable, and it's, you know, regular guy pizza.
Yeah.
So,
you know what? And I also, I kind of like the Two Boots. I mean, I got a soft spot for Two Boots.
Well, Two Boots.
I lived in New York for a while.
Yeah. And but, there's actually, there. I don't know if there's any on this list that, are these all 100% originals, the LA Weekly list? Do we check into that?
I haven't checked.
Okay.
I don't know.
Because that actually bugs me a little bit when you've got the other city transplant that comes in, and they're like, best in the city. I don't know.
Oh, it's not the best in the city, I don't think.
No, I'm just saying that, like, you know, when you, like Two Boots is the example
so
it's
saying,
of like, the restaurant coming from another city.
Right.
Because it's not an L.A. deal.
No, you're right. You're right.
Maybe I'm too strict about that.
Loosen up.
Forget that.
Loosen up, old man. Come on.
Right.
I think maybe that means it's time to meet today's guest.